Welcome back, students. In this video, we are going to see what are the different types of quantifiers and predicates. What are the definition of quantifiers and predicates? So first of all, we see what is the quantifier, and after that we see the predicate. So quantifier means the words like all, some, none, etc. indicate the quantity. So quantity, if any word knows about the quantity or tells about the quantity, then those are called as quantifiers. So here there are some of the words such as all, some, none, etc. So it indicates the quantity. So these are called as quantifiers. So simply we can say that quantifier means the words like all, some, none, etc. are indicates the quantity. So which the terms or words which indicates the quantity are simply called as quantifiers. So this is the definition of a quantifier. So quantifiers are divided into two types. Those are, number one is universal quantifier, and number two is extensional quantifier. So universal means for all. For all is called as universal quantifier, and there exist is called as extensional quantifier. So quantifiers are divided into two types. One is universal and another one is extensional quantifier. Universal means for all. For all is used as universal quantifier. There exist is used as extensional quantifier. Now we are going to listen this about a detail. So here universal quantifier. So the universal quantifier means all is called as universal quantifier, and we shall denote it by for all. The symbol for all is, for all is this. So this symbol we have to use in universal quantifier, which is in an inverted comma followed by the variable. So we can take any variable. If we consider a x variable, then simply we can say that for all x, so it is a universal quantifier. So simply if we ask what is the define the universal quantifier, then simply we can say that the quantifier all is called as universal quantifier, and we shall denote it by symbol for all followed by a variable x. Next one is extensional quantifier. We already know extensional quantifier means there exist. See, the quantifier sum is called as extensional quantifier, and we denote it by symbol this. This is used for extensional quantifier. This is also called as there exist. So which is reverse to E. So this symbol is same as reverse to E. So it is called as extensional quantifier symbol. So followed by a variable x. So there exist x for some x, or we can simply write for some x, or there exist an x such that, or there exist an at least one x. Such type of equation, such type of are called as such type of sum x. There exist for there exist of x such that, or x there exist on x. Such type is called as extensional quantifier. So universal quantifier means for all is called as universal quantifier, and extensional quantifier means there exist is called as extensional quantifier. Now we are going to see some of the examples. See, consider the statement John is a politician. John is a politician. Here John is the subject. John is called as a subject. What is John? John is a politician. So is a politician is a predicate. So simple way, by seeing the simple example, we can easily say that what is predicate and what is subject. So here John is a politician. Who is John? He is a politician. John is a subject, and is a politician is a predicate. So simple by this example we can easily define. So denote the predicate is a politician symbolically by the predicate letter. So predicate, it is having letter P, so symbolically we denote it by P. And by using by subject also we can denote it by simply by yes or here I am having taking John. So I will take subject by the word, first word of John, that is J. So next, predicate. Predicate means a predicate or propositional function is a statement containing variable. So predicate means simply I can say that a predicate or propositional function, it is a statement which contains variables. The contained variables may be P, Q, R, or any variables may be. It is called as a predicate. So here the statement John is a politician can be written as P of J. That means John is a politician in general. Here P of XY is a predicate involving two variables X and Y. See, here I am taking an example. So L of XY means X likes Y. So L of XY, what is the meaning of L of XY? X likes Y. Here L denotes the predicate likes. L means likes. What he likes? He likes X and Y. So X and Y are two persons. So L denotes predicate likes X and Y. Who he likes? X and Y. Then I will see some of the possibilities exist in the predicates. So these are the possibilities. T See, I have written again here, L of xy means x likes y. Here L denotes the predicate likes, and x and y are two persons, they like x and y, then the following possibilities occur. Here by using the quantifiers, I will easily see some of the statements. See here, number one, first statement is, for all x, for all y, L of xy. For all means universal, everybody likes everybody. That means x is loved by everybody, y is loved by everybody. That means everybody likes everybody. So this is easily we can say this for all x, for all y, L of xy means for all means everybody. See here, for all x, there exists y. For all means for x and there exists for y. That means for all is universal, there exists is existential. So everybody likes somebody. Everybody likes somebody. So this is the statement. Next, there exists. There exists means a few. For all means more. There exists x, for all y, L of xy. That means somebody likes everybody. This is the statement for the condition. Next, there exists y, for all x, L of xy. That means there is somebody. There exists means somebody. There is somebody who is liked by everybody. For all means everybody. There exists means somebody. For all means everybody. So there is somebody who is liked by everybody. So this is the statement here. Next, for all y, there exists x. For all means everybody. There exists means somebody. So everybody is liked by somebody. This statement is this. So there exists somebody. There exists somebody. So somebody was liked by somebody. Here he is given two existential quantifiers. That is, there exists. There exists means somebody. So somebody is liked by somebody. Next, there exists y, there exists x, there exists y of L of xy. Somebody likes somebody. Next, for all y, for all x, everybody is liked by everybody. So these are some of the possibilities in writing the predicates by using the quantifiers for every and also there exist. So for every means, for all means it is an universal quantifier, and there exist means it is an existential quantifier. So this is about the universal quantifiers and the existential quantifiers, about the quantifiers and also about the predicates.